In the next three lessons, we will explore a dataset that resembles user activity on Facebook. But before we get to that dataset, I need to show you how to read in data that doesn't come with R, and how to subset that data. It turns out that not all datasets can be easily loaded, like the empty cars dataset. In the instructor notes, you can find a link to download a new dataset. This dataset is going to contain information on the 50 states in the US. Most of the data comes from about 1970. Before we can read in the data, we need to set our current working directory. So to figure out what directory you're in now, you can type in git wd. We can run this command and see the output to the console. It looks like I'm already in the downloads file, and that also appears here in the top of my console. So I don't need to change my directory, but maybe you do. To change your directory, you can type set wd. This will take a string which will be the file path to whatever directory you want to go to. My guess is that your dataset is in your downloads file, so I would probably run this command. Now, it's important to note that whether or not you're on a Mac or Windows machine, you still need to separate your paths or your folders with a forward slash. Also, be sure that you use quotes around your path. Now, in order to load up the data, we can use the read.csv command. This command takes a string, which is the name of the file, and here we're going to pass it to a variable called statesInfo. StatesInfo is going to save all of our data into a data frame. When I run this code, I can see that StatesInfo appears in my environment. I can double-click on the data frame in the workspace, and this will let me see the table of values in our studio. Now, let's say I wanted to get information on states located in only the Northeast. Those states would be states like Connecticut, and they have a state region of 1. I'm going to go back to my R script and write a command that pulls in this data. The subset command would look like this. Here, I'm passing the data frame StatesInfo to subset, and I'm asking for it to retrieve any states that have a state.region equal to 1. When I run this code, I can see the output down below. We have Connecticut, Maine, and many others. Now, there is another way to subset this data frame, and I want to show you it just so that way you don't get confused later if you see it. It uses bracket notation where we have the name of our dataset followed by two brackets, and we'll have a comma in between. This first spot is for the rows of our dataset that we want to keep, and the second spot is for the columns that we want to keep. So if I want only the states in the Northeast, I would write this code. The name of the dataset is StatesInfo, and then I want the rows that have a state region equal to 1. Now, I can't just use state region here. I need to access the actual variable, so I'll have to put StatesInfo and the dollar sign. This gives me the actual variable value, and I can see if it's equal to 1. If it is equal to 1, I want to return every single column in the data frame. So for example, with Connecticut, if its state region is equal to 1, I want to return every single column in this row. To return all of the columns, I'll just leave this blank. So this code searches for rows that have a state region equal to 1, and then it takes all the columns in that row. And all of this will be sent to the console as a new data frame. Now, it might not be so helpful to have this output just in the console, so we can save these subsets into new variables. I'm also going to include some functions to print out the first two rows of each data frame and also their dimensions. Hopefully, I've convinced you that they're the same data set. Now, I really want you to pay careful attention to the syntax in both of these examples. Throughout this course, we tend to make use of the subset command, but there might be instances where we use this. Just know that both methods produce the same result. Now, I recommend that you try subsetting this data frame for other regions of the country on your own. You could also try finding out which states have an illiteracy rate of 0.5%, or which states have high school graduation rates above 50%. Feel free to play around.